Hello friends, this is the micro video on geopolitics of Kartarpur corridor. A corridor of faith being built in an environment of political uncertainties. Still there are bit doubts in the mind whether it will be completed or it will be given to the people of Punjab on both ends to satisfy their religious sentiments. But once the countries give a date and that is considered as a promise and it is counted onto the international credibilities, since both the countries have given the 550th anniversary of Guru Nanak and the corridor will be given to the communities of Punjab and the Punjab of Pakistan or to the other end, so that they may have religious, you can say, satisfaction of having a glimpse of the holy shrines, so that will fulfill somewhere, you can say optimism is there into the mind. One thing we have to keep in mind, India and Pakistan have already four wars. They had fought in 1948, 1965, 71 and 1999. It has always been found that the gain of one is a loss of other. Anything that has been written, something as an accord yesterday, is considered anachronistic, completely irrelevant today. And the countries keep on passing statements of abrogation, cancelling out, repealing whatever they had written into the past. We must understand here in front of you, it is Atal Bihari Vajpayee who had made a very forceful initiative along with Nawaz Sharif about the Kartarpur corridor in Delhi, Lahore, bus diplomacy, 1999, it's written in front of you. And Parvez Musharraf by then had done all required and consent was given, and with the help of Pakistan Gurdwara Prabandhak Committee, designs were made and plans were chalked out, and there was a willingness on the behalf of the brass of the armed forces of Pakistan, Kartarpur to be converted into reality. Now if we see the picture of the corridor, it looks like this. River Ravi is there and its right bank tributary. On the other end is Pakistan, on this side is India, and this is going to be the corridor. Not, you can say, quite big, it's barely 4 kilometers. What will be the modus operandi? How it's going to be brought into the workable conditions? So these things are being, you can say, discussed at war footing. But one thing we have to keep in mind, nearly 20,000 Sikhs are living in Pakistan and 2.5 crore Sikhs are living on the Indian side. They have their religious, you know, sentiments involved into it. There is, you can say, not one, two or three, multiple Sikh shrines are there in Pakistan. Similarly, lots of Sufi shrines are here in India. Keeping this thing in mind, there was a protocol that was signed in 1974 that gives, you can say, the consent of the government and an opportunity to the people to visit the shrines in both the nations. This protocol of visiting to the religious shrines 1974 is honored even in the case of, you can say, animosities at the highest level. But there are always delays on occasions when conditions go worst. It's not only Kartarpur Sahib, this is Gurdwara Janavasthan and Gurdwara Panja Sahib. There are so many other, you can say, where similar kind of feasibilities and viabilities can be worked out. The Kartarpur corridor may be a confidence building measure, but somewhere India has passed on the feelers that this is not going to be a game changer. If we see the geopolitical aspects, the way Pakistan has been strangulated, put under pressure by the international community, they just want to pass on messages to India for negotiations and peacemaking. The country is completely insolvent at this moment. Their foreign exchange reserves are almost nil. They cannot bear expenditure of heavy shellings across the border, and they can, we can say, arrange further ammunition. Everything will be there onto the soft and the hard loans. How long Saudi Arabia and China will keep on giving, you can say, the foreign reserves exchange, you can say, in terms of dollars to Pakistan? It's already there onto the minus side. So somewhere we are of this opinion, this bankrupt and insolvent Pakistan is in need of a kind of solace across the borders at this moment. Though you shape it as Naya Pakistan of Imran, we say this is not a Naya Pakistan, this is a bankrupt, you can say, Pakistan of Imran, and that is bound to play a softer, you can say, stance or the game with India till it's going to recover its foreign exchange reserves. Let's see once again the sketch, India side and the Pakistan side and River Ravi, and then the Dera Baba Nanak and Narowal part. Now, five things we have to keep in mind. 550th anniversary of Guru Nanak is going to see this Kartarpur corridor dedicated to the communities across the border. Across the river Ravi between Shakargarh Tehsil of Narowal district and of Pakistan and Dera Baba Nanak Tehsil of Gurdaspur of India, this river Ravi has a tendency to shift westward like rest of the rivers of Indus Basin. One thing you have to keep in mind, all the rivers of Ganga, its tributaries, they are shifting eastward, and all the tributaries of river Indus and Indus itself are shifting towards westward. This river Ravi is having shifting nature, and that is the basic reason behind, you can say, this problem that has come onto the forefront. A part of Kartarpur is on this side and the part of Kartarpur is there on the other side. Once it was there entirely onto one side there. So this is the long-standing demand of the Sikhs. It would have been fulfilled by 1947 onwards when the massacres of the people of Punjab had taken place. Yes, Bhakra Nangal project had been given to the people of Punjab. This is a nourishing touch. This was a remedial soothing balm, the way the DVC, the Damodar Valley Corporation, had been given to the people of West Bengal, those who also suffered at the time of partition. But this kind of corridor was also indispensable by then. But if we say this is not too late, let's do the necessary things and convert it there into the reality. If we see closely, we will get the picture of the destination where the connection by the corridor will be made. Construction work is going on and corridor is under construction. Again, let's see the same photograph, how on Indian side and onto the Pakistan side, you can say, corridor will be made. Now, for the first time, it has been found that the army of Pakistan and the civilian leadership, the present government, they are on the same page. This kind of thing had rarely happened. No one can deny that Imran Khan's emergence as a prime minister is propelled by the armed forces itself. Bajwa is behind Imran Khan's promotion as a prime minister. But for the first time, it has been found that this civilian leadership and the army, they are onto the same side. And some sort of sincerity in Kartarpur corridor is seen, not by India, but by the world press also. It is very rosy to think of India-Pakistan cooperation over Kartarpur as the dawn of the new thaw, the melting in bilateral ties, but grander outreaches in the past have fallen prey to the Pakistan betrayals. I said in the beginning, there is always, you can say, trust deficit between the two nations. We had found number of times Pakistan prevaricating, changing its statements. But here in this case of Kartarpur corridor, somewhere we find, yes, things are going to convert into reality very soon. There are a couple of, you can say, political opinions which have come onto the fray. Lots of politicians, geopoliticians, and the press people, they see that Kartarpur corridor is going to be the strategic vulnerability for India. Let's take it as a point. Kartarpur corridor is a sensitive issue among the Sikh community. It is easy to see as a low-hanging fruit for 2019 general elections. So this is, you know, you can say, another opinion that has been passed on by the press. Right? To woo, you can say, the part of the community, the people of the country. This was the low-hanging root. Low-hanging fruit. Right? And it has been encashed. Who is instrumental? We had seen already the previous NDA government, they were instrumental in 1989. Efforts were made earlier also. But the concerted effort we had seen, you can say, at a time when Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the Prime Minister. 50 years back, this is the Sushant Sareen's statement. It's a very derogatory statement he had passed. It's a very linguistic way of thinking. Now what he said, that 50 years back we had the 5th Sentinel anniversary, which by all counts had the greater salience than this 500th anniversary. If the Sikh faith could survive and thrive without the corridor, the heavens wouldn't have fallen if there was no corridor on the 550th anniversary. I said that every part of the society had reflected their opinion. They have passed on the comments. So these kind of ideas were also picked up by the newspapers. Somewhere people are unhappy on the proceedings. But on the greater part, it's going to be, you can say, a kind of solace for the people of Punjab on both ends. This corridor is a necessity. Pakistan is reeling under international pressure. It has complete insolvency. Its foreign exchange reserves are almost exhausted. Foreign aid, for being the most reliable non-NATO partner, has reduced. It won't be sustainable for it to engage into a limited war or a global segregation. It's a compulsion, media says. Pakistan is bound to pass on, you can say, the friendly feelers to India. Now let's see the geopolitical aspects. Aspect number one. China has made investments in BRI and wishes good relations with India and Pakistan for a flourishing trade across its corridor. CPEC had seen nearly $62 to $65 billion investments. If it is not going to work, if India is not going to use it, that is making 17.5% population of the world. It's a big market. Right? If it is not going to send its products to the Central Asia, to Afghanistan, to Iran, to Pakistan, and from there the goods are coming to India, and China is also going to be a part of it, then the entire $1 trillion investment of the BRI will be of no use. How Pakistan is going to repay its debt? Like Sri Lanka, like Tajikistan and Malaysia, it has to pass on its land on larger equities and lease of, you can say, hundreds of years. So that's going to be a problem for Pakistan. It has to come out of its economic insolvency, bankruptcy, and they have to make use these big corridors that it had made. They are not meant only for China, they are meant for the entire world. Central Asia can use the Indian Ocean seaboard by using CPEC kind of thing. A few changes if are made in accordance with India, India will definitely be a part of it. They have to respect the sovereignty of India. So this is the first aspect, this is a compulsion of China and Pakistan that India should be a part of it and there should be a bonhomie, a friendly environment over there. Aspect number two, trilateral compellence. A country that is having maximum trade with the two enemy nations is bound to play the role of a mediator. China is having huge trade with India, China is having trade with Pakistan, and China is going to have this stance of trilateral compellence and is bound to play a role of a mediator. It is going to pass on information to India about the pileups that had taken place, you can see 1999, across the line of control and line of actual control. The actual ground position line. So they are supposed to pass on the information so that the major conventional war can be avoided. So that it's, you can say, the corridors may run day in and day out, 24/7. So somewhere this is the compulsion of China to make these two countries have bonhomie and economic environment in intact, you can say, atmosphere. Same kind of efforts USA had made in 2001-2002 of trilateral compellence to avoid the belligerence between the two nations. Saudi Arabia is also having the same kind of intention to play the trilateral compellence to be a mediator between India and Pakistan and to minimize their, you can say, the problems. Aspect number three, Imran's near Pakistan seeks bonhomie with India. Pakistan will prefer all the routes to Central Asia must pass through its territory. If India is going to promote international south-north corridor, north-south corridor through Iran, is going to surpass Pakistan, that will be not in the favor of Pakistan there. So somewhere that kind of Kartarpur corridor is a feeler of Pakistan, of forthcoming good relations with India. This is a compulsion to get rid of the economic, the consequences of insolvency they are suffering from. Aspect number four, Pakistan has been trying its best to revive the separatist movement in Punjab. This is a very strong feeling among the people of Punjab here, people of India here. Flushing the state with narcotics for the last several years is the part of plan. The ISI back with the Sikh referendum 2020 campaign. So this kind of thing is going on. But it can be seen as an attempt to gain Sikh sympathy. Sikh pilgrims from India would get poisoned easily is a bit of a stretch. Most pilgrims are keen to pay obeisance at the Kartarpur. But if we're going to see from this prism, then definitely we must talk about the propriety of the Sikh community itself. Why they are going to indulge again into the same kind of things which had completely derailed the economics of Punjab between 1973 and 1993. Correctness of the behavior is to be expected from the community of Punjab. If some outsider is going to promote the separatist tendencies, somewhere there is a national character into the people of Punjab also there, they are going to say no. Let them influence. Gradually they will be able to understand that the people are having, you can say, a different kind of determination. They are nationalists. Now they are not going to be giving them a kind of leverage to bank upon them and create problem into Punjab. Let's talk about the propriety on the behalf of Sikhs here. Aspect number 5, opening up the other religious routes like Shraddha Peeth for the Hindus, that will not be far away. That is again the possibility there. Tourism potential can further be promoted by extending the Sufi and the Sikh circuits in both the countries. Aspect number 6, both Punjabs of India as well as of Pakistan have sensed an opportunity. Towns in the border belt of Punjab believe that the opening of the corridor is going to increase the boost, the trade will get a boost. The one thing we have to keep in mind, phase 3 of the international relations says that the geopolitics and the geonomics go hand in hand. Let the economics make its conspicuous role, right? Rivalries will be there, but economics should not come to an end. It should not be altered. Trade should go up. One thing you have to keep in mind, greater will be the bilateral trade between the India and Pakistan, larger will be the strong of India onto the Pakistan. Pakistan tries to engage India into the multilateral trade links. India tries to engage Pakistan into the bilateral. This is the simple principle of international relations. Aspect number 7. Initial views about the resumption of the talks on Kartarpur corridor. Somewhere, this is a goodwill gesture and is going to bring India onto the dialogue tables. Other things will also be into the fray. India has maintained a very strong stance against Pakistan. It has increased the taxes, right, onto the products which come to India from Pakistan. Trade has almost, you can say, slided to the minimum. So somewhere they are of this opinion that this is going to be an opening for the broader discussions. The Pakistan's efforts can be seen, that is aspect number 8, as a part of the Bajwa doctrine. What is this Bajwa doctrine? The doctrine that seeks good relationships of Pakistan in its neighborhood. Kartarpur corridor may prove a catalyst and SAARC deadlock will break. Regional forum, though that is not in favor of India, will again re-establish and this Islamabad talks will start again. And somewhere India has taken a very rigid stance into the Istanbul process, heart of Asia talks. Right? In the favor of Afghanistan against Pakistan, it has made almost every country of the SAARC nations to pass on their views against Pakistan. Almost you can say it is isolated in the regional forum and it's nearly to be declared a rogue nation, a terrorist state. It just wants to mild down its stance. Aspect number 9 says, vindictiveness has given Pakistan its nuclear deterrence and it has further stopped the balkanization. Had not been Pakistan equipped itself with nuclear capabilities, it would have been further balkanized. Something it has understood in 1971 and in 1983-84 it has got the nuclear capabilities. Though it has tested in 1998, declared in 1998, but it cannot defer its development part. And the aspect number 10 is very important. Pakistan at this moment is having a demographic burden. It's having huge population with you can say demographic dividend. They are, you can say, have able bodied. They have two hands to work, but where is the employment? So they are in need of the economic facelift and they are in need of the good relationship with the neighboring countries. Though Imran Khan had passed on a statement, what statement was this? If France and Germany, which have killed millions of people, each other, can today be the part of the same union, the European Union, with open borders and enjoy trade, it is because their political leadership decided they do not want to remain in the past. What had happened in the past, they are not going to recall it. They have said that the contemporary world and their today's relationship is more important. People of Punjab on both ends suffered a lot at the time of partition. Kartarpur corridor and many more were required immediately by them, but it is not too late. The corridor will be a stimulus for similar problems in South Asia. Today, India and Pakistan are having this kinds of corridor, right? The way India and Bangladesh have gone for a very effective exchange of the exclaves and enclaves, the problem is sorted forever. So similar kind of issues which are there across the border with the rest of the nations can also be sorted out. It can be a good example. Thank you.